Adaptive tracing for the Presto engine is a technique that solves difficult lighting scenarios, such as caustics from point lights. One great example of these are the sandpool caustics, which were previously impossible to achieve with Presto. Adaptive tracing is also capable of solving efficiently lighting coming from small or hidden area light sources. Let's first start with reflective and refractive caustics. Caustics can be produced when light is hitting highly reflective surfaces such as metals or passing through transparent surfaces like glass. In this scene, we have both reflective and refractive caustics showing us noise in the final image. When enabling adaptive tracing, it is evident that the caustics are now well defined. Both refractive and reflective caustics appear in the rendered image. Adaptive tracing is controlled by two options: Clamp Firefly and the Caustics option. Clamp Firefly will eliminate or suppress high-frequency noisy paths that are difficult to sample. The suppression is further controlled by the clamping value, which is 1 by default. This is the result when Clamp Firefly is set to on. Finally, the Caustics option enables sampling of additional lighting paths that can result in a more efficient caustic calculation. As we can see in this example, there is a great difference in the way caustics appear in the rendered image. Besides generating caustics more efficiently, there are also other cases of difficult indirect lighting that can be improved. As an example, we can have scenes with multiple light bounces between diffuse surfaces, called diffuse interreflection. Let's take the classic Cornell box and flip the light's direction so that it first hits the ceiling. With this move, we made sure that the rest of the scene will have no direct light and the only light will be the one bouncing off from the ceiling. We just turned a very simple scene into a very demanding one, given also that the size of the light is quite small. To make a proper comparison, we set equal time limit when rendering the scene with and without adaptive tracing. The first shot has been rendered with adaptive tracing turned off, which is also the default setting. As you can see, there is a lot of noise in the image caused by the reflected light from the ceiling. Let's see how adaptive tracing can help in this case. This is how the scene looks with the option turned on. The Presto engine was able to solve the difficult light paths with less noise, creating also a higher dynamic range image. While adaptive tracing performs better in cases where the scene is illuminated mostly by difficult indirect lighting, there is no benefit when there is a dominant direct lighting, and in this case the default setting should be preferred. Finally, we will see how to enable adaptive tracing in both SketchUp and Rhino. In Thea for SketchUp, click on the Thea tool icon in the toolbar to open the Thea tool panel. Switch to the Rendering tab and open the Adaptive Tracing rollout. Enable Adaptive Tracing by ticking the checkbox. In Thea for Rhino, switch to the Thea Render panel and from the Rendering tab expand the Adaptive Tracing rollout. Enable Adaptive Tracing by ticking the checkbox.